Hello everyone, happy new year to you. Happy 2020 to you. I hope your new year was fantastic and I hope it was grandiose. Okay, I am Sarah and this is my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be talking about how to set goals for 2020. So let's just get the intro and move on to how to do this thing. Alright, for the purpose of being very, very accurate and for the fact that, okay, I do not want to look as if I am cramming or anything, I'm going to be looking at my notes on the tips I've actually written down on how to set our goals for 2020. Now, it's not big news to anyone that, okay, this is a new year and we actually want to get things done. We actually want to see transformation and improvement in our lives, and hence why we should set goals, because goals actually help to transform us, it actually helps to improve us, and it boosts our self-confidence when you actually know that, yeah, I set this and I actually did it. So number one, be real, be realistic. It's not a wish list, it's not a wish list, okay? It's not something that is, you just feel like, okay, you can write anything that you feel like you should write that are not very practical. Be realistic, be practical about it, and be real about when it comes to being realistic. It's actually split into two parts for me. It's number one, be real what you know would happen, and number two, what you want to happen. Be realistic with yourself. What do you know that this will happen and you want to happen? Don't write down things that you know that you don't care about at all. Then your goal should be proactive. Your goal should be proactive in the sense that it is part of your big plan in life. So you are doing what, you are actually doing a goal for yourself now that you know that's going to help you in the future. For example, if you are a student who has not gotten into school and your goal is to actually like read like 8 to 10 hours every day, or okay, let me say 6 to 8. Let's say 6 to 8 hours every day. What's the reason? What's the big plan attached to it? It's because why? You want to pass your WAEC, you want to pass your NECO, you want to pass your JAMB and get into school. The big plan is to get into school. So for a worker, if you're actually planning that, okay, you want to actually build a house in the less than 2-3 years, you want to be done with this tenancy life, you want to be done with tenant life and everything, what are you doing right now? You are saving up to buy a land, and now that it should be part of your big plan, it should be proactive. Then the next one is actually, it should span from January to December. People really have this kind of thing where they go about packing all the things they want to do in the first three months of the year. But I believe that if it spans from January to December, it will actually be easier. Like you, that tension of you want to do this, you want to do that, it will be easier. And the more you see yourself, okay, maybe if you have, let's say 24 goals in for a year, and every month you split it up, you do 2 goals every month, the more you conquer goal one, you conquer goal two, you feel more confident to actually go ahead and do the other ones that might be bigger or might be more that might involve more effort. So just divide it, have something to do every month. When you're telling people happy new month, you're actually telling yourself happy new goal to me, like happy new assignments I need to do for this month. Okay, then the next one, you should know how to go about your goals. You should know how, like, you're not just writing down things and just not knowing how to go about it. Like I'm really happy that I've actually been involved in some kind of positions and some kind of things that, and I was asked the question, how are you going to go about it? And I started looking like so when you don't know how to go, the thing about it is that once you don't know how to fulfill your goal, it's going to be a wish list. So unless you know how to fulfill that goal, you have only written down a wish list. Okay, then the next one is, and this one's another heading entirely, but you can attach it and just put it, tips on how to accomplish your goal. You know how to set them now. You know what are the essential things that qualify a thing to be goals for you. Then the next thing should be, how am I going to accomplish it? Number one, write it down. Write it down. Because when you write things down, you tend not to forget. And when you write and you really go ahead and you let's say you write down your goals and you explain the how, you explain the why, you how to go about it, why should I go about this, it actually makes you that in the later on, when it's time to fulfill it, or when it's time to that you feel that okay, I shouldn't do this anymore, you read that, you can, that fire can actually spark up and you can actually go about fulfilling your goal, accomplishing your goal. Then the next one is have a constant reminder. Most times we say things in January and we do not do them at all till the end of the year. I'll be like, oh, I said I would do it. So it's when you have to write another goal, you now remember again. No, have a constant reminder. For example, if your aim or your goal is to actually get to actually read 15 books in a year, what is that? Is it your calendar? Is it your alarm? Are you pasting things on the wall? And I would actually love it and suggest that every month you should just write down the things that you want to like do and just put them somewhere that you can actually see it. For me, I'm going to get a planner, and that planner, I'm going to write down the things that I am going to do like in for every month, for every week. I would actually the planner I'm going to get is the student planner by I Am Yen Chi. And if you don't have that, you can actually use a notebook, because this notebook I have right here actually wrote down my plans for the year. But I just want a planner because I want to break it down, and I just want to have that. Oh, I have a planner and open it every time and tick and all that. Then the next one is set something as a reward for fulfilling your goal. What is the gift you are giving thyself for the stress? Okay, so yeah, your goal is, this is not necessary, it's not mandatory, but it's just a suggestion for yourself, because for many people, maybe due to the way you were trained or due to how stressful a goal can be, there is a need to actually reward yourself. It might just be a need to reward yourself. Just pour yourself a little. What are you doing to set something as a reward? And don't give yourself that reward if you have not fulfilled that goal. So if the reward is that I'm going to buy myself a car as a worker, I started working, and I'm going to buy myself, I'm going to change my car. Yeah, I'm going to change my car to the big thing. I have not fulfilled that goal. No. Oh yeah, a student, you want to buy yourself a certain shoe. I have not fulfilled that goal. No. So that you look at them like, oh, I didn't get it because I didn't do my goal. I mean, actually, it will be better that way. Like, let's be more disciplined about it. Then set a gift, buy yourself something. Then know constantly that it is a way to improve you. When you have this thing in your mind that, oh, goal is not to suffer myself, it's not for me to stress, it's not for me to I'm not killing myself here. I'm not torturing myself by setting a goal. I'm not wounding myself. It's actually to improve me. One thing that goal setting actually helps, goal setting and conquering actually helps, is that it improves your discipline. Like, you become more disciplined. I think it's easy to actually say that, okay, I want to read 15 books in a year and sit down and read those 15 books in that year that you've actually broken down. It's actually very great to see that you are able to do that. The more goals you set, the more you conquer them, the more disciplined you get. Okay, so I don't want to make this video very, very long. I just wanted to say what I wanted to say, that these are my own suggestions, and I hope you have a wonderful year. You set your goals right, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share to your friends, and also subscribe so that the next time I am doing another video, next time I post a next video, you'll be the first person to see it. And who doesn't want to be the first person to see videos? Like, who doesn't want to be the first to be informed? Okay, and that's it. Bye bye. Thank you. Hey.